I'm a second year student, PhD student Chetna, working in LNCE, and now I'll be showing you colloidal chemistry and how it's done. It's very similar to cooking. So just like in cooking, we start with the cooking pan. So here we have a three-neck flask, which is our reactor. And then we need a lid to cover the cooking pan usually. So similarly, we have a Schlenk line here, which we use to control the environment in which we do the reactions. It's possible to change the flow of gases in the flask from nitrogen to vacuum or whatever gases we need. And then usually while cooking, what we do is we add oil on a pan and we start heating up the oil. Similarly, we use in colloidal chemistry, we use organic solvents for the reaction to take place. So we put the organic solvents and we start heating up. And then usually we use the main ingredient in the cooking into the hot oil. Similarly, we put metal precursors, which we use to make these kinds of metal oxide or perovskite nanocrystals. So we put the precursors and we start the recipe, which is the reaction, and then we continue the procedure. Usually, depending on the different oil that we use for cooking, the fragrance or the taste of the dish also changes. So depending if we use coconut oil or olive oil or sunflower oil, the dishes that we make is different. So similarly, the solvents that we use here actually define the structure, the nanocrystal shape and size. By changing these organic solvents, it's possible to change the crystal from a sphere to a cube or a rod, etc. And at the end of the reaction, we always have these crystals in organic solvents, it's very nice because we can process it very well. So here what I have is copper nanocrystals dispersed in hexane. And you can see, and this is actually a copper foil in bulk, and this is a copper nanocrystals in solution. As you can see, the color is very different. So the properties of these material change when we go from bulk to nanoparticles, which is why it's very interesting to study these kind of nanomaterials, which is what we do in our lab.